Helen Xiang from Dunman High School. Today we are presenting our project, designing a panel for detection of Helminthiasis in stool sample by using lab-on-chip technology. This project focuses on the design of a lab-on-chip panel which employs a combination of multiplex PCR and microarray technology. According to the World Health Organization report in 2000, there are approximately 9.99 million people suffering from helminthiasis each year. The traditional diagnostic methods are time-consuming and require trained personnel to look for and identify the eggs. The lab-on-chip technology, on the other hand, has high specificity and sensitivity, requiring a low parasite load for detection and thus ensures a timely administration of medication to infected individuals. It also eases the detection since an automated thermal cycling system, chip reader, and computer software was employed for determination of specific helminths. Therefore, the objective of this project is to design a lab-on-chip panel which can be used to detect the presence of common gastrointestinal helminths in human feces in order to improve efficiency and accuracy of helminth detection.
As for methodology, firstly, we obtained the primers and probes of the helminths that we aim to study from the existing journal articles as they have been validated by the previous researchers.
Then, we tested the specificity by using BLAST. Those were non-specific to certain helminths were replaced by an additional primer or probe found by Primer 3+. The specific primers and probes would be subjected to simulation using visual OMP with annealing temperature for primers and hybridization temperature set at 60 plus minus 5 degrees Celsius. There were three types of simulation being carried out: primer versus targets, primer versus primers, and probe versus amplicons. Those did not fulfill the criteria were modified by extending or replacing the primer or probe. After that, the validated probes were used for panel design with a few necessary controls to ensure the detection proceeded correctly.
By analyzing the simulation results between primers, primer and target sequences, or probe and amplicons, some primers and probes were found to be unsuitable for use in the panel design due to the low percentage of appropriate binding.
Primers or probes that did not fulfill the criteria mentioned have been modified. Table 1 shows the primers that have been modified. 27% of the primers which show cross-interactions or monomers formation were modified to increase specificity. 80% of the probes obtained from journal articles were also modified due to their low percentage of binding. The monomer or hairpin formation during simulation will give rise to a great chance of cell binding and reduces crack binding between the probe and amplicons or primer and target sequences. The problem was solved by replacing or extending the primers or probes in order to avoid corresponding bases from pairing with each other, forming a hairpin. A panel based on the validated probes and necessary controls, including negative controls, PCR controls, and hybridization controls, was designed. Here is an example of how a positive detection of spirometer uranus europae will appear. Each corresponding light spot represents one probe used in the panel. By comparing this image with the panel that was designed, the specific helminths present in the sample will be revealed. After analysis, a table of final diagnostic results will be generated. In this way, the diagnostic processes are simplified to an accurate and time-saving way.
As for discussion, by modifying and replacing some unacceptable primers or probes, high percentage of self-binding primers and probes were avoided. However, there were interactions between the primers or probes with other target sequences. These primers and probes, in the case of Fasciola hepatica and Fasciolopsis fasci, were used as universal primers and probes for amplification and generic detection. Another set of specific probes was designed to differentiate between the two. We also found that certain probes were not specific. They were bind with more than one target sequence during simulation. Thus, in the case of Schistosoma mansoni and Entamoeba histolytica, criteria were set to avoid misdiagnosis of these two infections.
A final panel of 26 helminths with high specificity, sensitivity, and ease of use was developed for diagnostic purposes based on literature review and dry lab simulation. However, wet lab optimization followed by validation using real samples are required before actual use for diagnosis. Thank you for watching.